Buddy didn't bother to set his alarm to go jogging on Friday morning. He could hardly get out of bed, let alone run. His ribs were sore, and his knees felt as though they were wrapped in cardboard. The dull ache that throbbed in his ankle exploded into real pain with each step he took. His father was late leaving for work. Buddy took advantage of the opportunity to catch a ride to school in Sergeant Riley's squad car. "Have a good day," his father said as Buddy got out of the car. "I'll be praying for you this afternoon when you're trying out for track." "Thanks, Dad." Buddy's smile was lopsided. "See you tonight." Buddy waited until his father's car went around the corner before he turned and limped toward the school building. When he went into the hallway, someone darted out and grabbed his elbow. It was Sam Runyon, and his face looked scared. "I need to know something," he said hurriedly. "Listen, I know we were real mean to you yesterday, and Kyle hurt you pretty bad, but..." Sam stopped and looked over his shoulder. He looked back at Buddy, fear in his eyes. We just gotta know, though. You didn't tell your dad on us, did you? Please say you didn't, because I'll get in terrible trouble if you did. Did you tell your dad? Did you?" He hovered next to Buddy, waiting for his answer. Buddy shook his head. "No, I didn't," he said quietly. "Sam, where's Kyle?" "He couldn't come today," Sam said, biting his lip. He got hurt last night, too." "Is he all right?" Buddy asked. "How badly is he hurt?" He'll be okay, I guess." Sam looked over his shoulder again. "Sam," Buddy said, "I want you to tell Kyle something for me. Can you do that?" "This is important," Buddy told him. "Tell Kyle that bad stuff happened to Jesus, too. Tell him that Jesus does love him and that he'll forgive him, just like I forgive him. Can you remember that, Sam?" "I think so," Sam answered. He turned away and pushed the door open. "Where are you going?" Buddy asked him. "School's about to start. I gotta go," was all Sam said. He pushed through the door and ran. Buddy slowly turned around and walked to his classroom. Something important had just happened, but he wasn't exactly sure what it was. "God, please help Sam and Kyle," Buddy prayed under his breath. "I don't know what's going on, but you do. Keep them safe and help them to learn how much you really do love them." Well, the hours skimmed by. A math test took Buddy's mind off the Runyon boys. The video in English class helped him forget about the tryouts after school, at least for a little while. Soon the final bell rang. Michael and Terrence found Buddy in the hallway. "Hurry up," said Michael. "We're supposed to be changed and ready to go in 10 minutes. "You guys go ahead," Buddy told them. "I don't think I'm going to be able to run." "You can do it, Buddy," Terrence said. "We're counting on you to be on the team." Buddy shook his head. I twisted my ankle yesterday. There's no way I can run." "Sure you can," said Michael. "Shake it out. It'll be fine. You have to run or you can't be on the team." Buddy said. His ankle did feel a little better. In the locker room, Terrence rewrapped Buddy's ankle tightly. "How does that feel?" he asked. Buddy took a few steps and grinned. "Good enough to run, I think," he said. Maybe all that work would pay off after all. Soon the boys were lined up on the starting line. Mr. Vanderhoven stood in front of the bleachers, his clipboard and stopwatch ready. He blew the whistle and they were off, their pounding feet stirring up a cloud of dust on the dirt track. Buddy started out quickly, but soon settled into the steady pace he had become comfortable with on his early morning runs. Many boys were far ahead of him, but some were behind him. That was success enough for Buddy. He held his position for two laps, but then his ankle started hurting badly. "I hate running," Buddy panted as he jolted along. Slower and slower he ran. By the fourth lap, he was limping and hopping along, but he was determined to finish no matter what. Finally, it was over. He staggered across the chalk line and limped over to sit on the bleachers. He didn't have to look. He knew he had been the last one over the line. Buddy hung his head and struggled to catch his breath. Coach Vanderhoven sat down next to him. "That was quite a run," he said. "You did well." "I did?" asked Buddy, looking up in surprise. "Well, Michael told me about your ankle," Mr. Vanderhoven said. "I'm impressed that you kept going, even though you were hurting. That's a sign of a real athlete." "It is?" said Buddy. "Yes, sir," Mr. Vanderhoven continued. "Buddy, you really surprised me. I didn't think you'd be one of my runners. In fact, as soon as I saw you, I had you picked out for the shot put." Buddy stared at his coach. Shot put? He asked. You've never done that before? Why, you're practically made for it, said Mr. Vanderhoven. Come here and I'll show you. He led Buddy into the field to a place where a circle was marked on the ground. Stand here inside the circle, he said. He handed Buddy a heavy silver ball. This is called the shot, he told Buddy. The goal is to put the shot as far away as you can. Now hold the shot up next to your neck. Okay, now turn and crouch down with your back facing the field. You're going to turn and stand like this, and in one smooth motion, you'll push the shot up into the air and release it. Coach Vanderhoven showed Buddy how to stand, turn, and throw the shot. Then he stepped back. Now you try it. Go ahead. Buddy took the heavy ball and held it next to his neck. He crouched and stood poised, concentrating on what he would do next. Then quickly he turned and stood, pushing the shot out from his body and into the air. It arched and then landed with a thud several yards away. Mr. Vanderhoven whistled through his teeth. That's amazing, he said. You're a natural, Buddy. With a little training, you'll be the best shot putter in the district, maybe even in the state. Forget running, son. You were made for the shot put. Well, Buddy felt a smile slowly grow in his heart and spread to his face. Every cell in his body was smiling. Hadn't his mother said that God made people to be good at different things? Buddy had thought that, thinking he had to be a good runner to make the track team. But God had a better plan all along. And whether God's plan involved getting beat up or becoming a shot put champion, like Peter on the stormy sea, Buddy was learning to grab onto God's hand. And he knew God would not let him down. All right, well, we learned some good lessons with Buddy about perseverance, about forgiveness, and I'm so glad that we were able to get through that story. We've got more to read, and hopefully we'll be able to be back together to read some stories. In the meantime, you can always reach out, have Mom or Dad touch base with me on text message or FaceTime or on Facebook, and I'd love to hear from any of you and see how you're doing during this weird time apart. Let's pray, and then we'll be done for tonight. Our Heavenly Father, thank you. Thank you that you give us such a great example of how to show love. No greater example than your love for us, Lord. Thank you for the lessons we've learned in Patch Club over this month and over this patch year. Thank you for the lessons we learned from Buddy and the Willow Valley Gang. Lord, we pray that we'll just apply those to our lives. And Lord, we pray that you'll bring us back together soon. Keep our families safe and healthy and be with our pastor and our church leaders and our state and federal leaders as well. Lord, help them to make good decisions. And we just pray that you'll protect our nation, protect our church family, and help us to be able to see each other real soon. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.